Rob, hey, happy people, how are you all? We're connecting with you all the way in South Australia and WA, is that right?
Correct, yes.
Fantastic. Now, we're all about NAIDOC here at Australia Post and Star Trek. So I'm going to go around and ask you all to introduce yourself, and I'm going to ask you who's your mob and who's your job, right?
My name's Aaron Brock, and I'm the postal manager of Margaret River in Southwest WA.
Nice.
And I'm a Yamaji, is my mob.
My name's Damien Peasley. I'm here in South Australia. I work in retail as well. My family connections, my mob is the Narangeri. So we're down from the southeast, which is Kingston, Mount Gambier area.
Hi, Christine. Yes, well, my name's Beverly Wallum. My mob, I'm a Noongar woman from the Ballardong region, which is the Great Southern of WA. I work in Albany as a senior postal service officer.
Hey, Christine. My name is Kylie Kumkumither, and I'm a proud Kaurna and Noongar Mimini from Adelaide in South Australia. Currently, I'm working with the Colt SA team, so we're like a customer operational liaison team here in Adelaide, based in the Adelaide Mail Exchange.
Do you know a lot of Australians outside of your community that come and, you know, want to know more about NAIDOC?
Oh, I have the privilege of accompanying the state manager, Donna Becchio, to the Sydney 2018 National Awards. There was just lots of people asking lots of questions when I got back to find out what it was all about and what I was able to learn from the experience, which was awesome. So.
This year's theme, Damien, is always was, always will be. I always get choked up when I have to say that, because it's just, just all this pride just wants to come jumping out. What does it mean to you?
Yes, and that's exactly it. Pride is the main thing for me. You know, you've got to be proud of who we are, where we have come from, where we're continuing to go. You know, my mum's a big supporter, and I look up to my mum on what she's done. You know, and that's always was, always will be. You know, because, you know, you want to encourage more people to get involved and to recognise, you know, the First Nation people. You know, and for me, it's just, you know, spreading the word. You know, proud to wear the top, you know, which is, I get a lot of questions asked, and people love to, you know, sort of speak to about, you know, where your family is and what do you do and where do you get involved in, and just opening doors for other people.
That's wonderful. Now, we're celebrating NAIDOC and what it means for us. What is NAIDOC? What does it mean for you?
NAIDOC for me, it's a great time of the year because I started a grassroots netball program for the Indigenous girls in my region. So I use NAIDOC week and that day of leave to take usually around 50 girls to Perth, and we participate in the NAIDOC Netball Carnival. So, you know, to be able to expose the girls that wouldn't usually get that opportunity to go to Perth and play in that type of environment, for me, is so rewarding. And, you know, to win most of the competitions is just a bonus on top. So I absolutely love it.
Kylie, why should all Australians embrace and celebrate our First Nations culture and NAIDOC, actually?
So I can't believe we have a whole week to celebrate our culture. Like, to be able to bring everybody together that kind of keeps us and our culture alive. And if we can bring all Australians together, like, it's only going to help our future generations. It's only going to embrace us and bring us all together as one. And that's what I think we kind of want at the end of the day, is everyone to be as one. No more separations. Bring it all together and let's move forward, like, in a positive way. And it's only going to help our mob and Indigenous Australians. And it's just going to make our future so much better.
Beautiful. And on that note, I'm going to say nakanya.
Nakanya.
Bye. Bye, everyone. Thank you so much.